trying to get cameras in there, and you know, I wanted to shoot 16mm because I was a real artist. And I got to the border, and they wanted to search, like, there's a war going on, they wanted to search every can and thing. I was like, I'm not an artist, we're going to do it on video. And then I got there, and I just was a little bit cavalier about it, and then, you know, something happened, I think was kind of unexpected, and the rebels almost took the city, and people were really scared, and, you know, but I was really struck by the fact that, I mean, I got scared. I think this is actually scary. I'm going to go home. I'm not going to get out of this. But the people that lived there, and I imagine would be some kind of, you know, like panic or anything, streets or looting. In fact, you know, just, you know, trying to go to work, trying to, you know, take care of their families, sell what they needed to, going to the market, going to the city, going to the stores. And, yeah, it was something that really, really impressed me. But it's, you know, when you're living with conflict and war like that, at some level, folks get used to it, and it's pretty jarring.
That's sad, right? That people actually, kids and others, just become, war becomes a familiar place.
Yeah, one of the things that we're trying to do with DCI is we fund some of these community-based groups that are working with child soldiers. And again, because they know them, because they have relationships with them, they're able to get, particularly young girls, oftentimes kids as young as 9, 10, 11, and many, you know, 13, 14 is considered an adult, basically, are taken in by these militia organizations. And there are 24, 26 identified armed groups. And then there are also sort of Mai Mai, which are local sort of neighborhood militias, in essence. And one of the things that people are doing, some of the Congolese are doing that's really amazing, is that they're, you know, going out, it's heartbreaking, and getting these girls who are, you know, bush wives, which basically means that they've been raped repeatedly, working in these militias, and trying to bring them home and trying to find homes for them and trying to do you know, reintegration stuff. There's an organization called Let Africa Live that we're in the process of making a grant.